Sir, it's on you, your move,
said the sweet-looking blonde hostess sitting at the roulette table as Brick Daniels began to strategize his next move before answering.
4K Red 7.
Las Vegas, the city of sin, a mecca for the gamblers with the biggest pockets and for larger-than-life egos, and Brick Daniels ticked all those boxes. Caesar's Palace, the venue of choice for the smug-looking Arizona native, as he flexed his diamond-studded Rolex on his right hand for all those standing competitors at the roulette table to take notice of. A form of intimidation tactics to showcase the depth of his pockets. Brick Daniels, the right-hand man of Ted Cash's corporation at Champagne Wrestling, and the co-commentator analyst alongside Flex Remington. Brick was on a leave of absence, a stint off after his latest six-month run on analyst duties, a scripted scene where he was attacked backstage by the Mexican Revolution stable, headed up by its leader Hector Moreno, dubbed Mexican Machete, led to the perfect departure plan. Brick Daniels, a former wrestler in his own right in yesteryear, was seen as a future wrestling prodigy by Ernie Cash, the departed father of Ted Cash. Brick first laced up his boots as a 19-year-old fresh-faced pup in the indie circuit in the 1970s, making waves from the get-go, which brought many admirers to see his talents in the flesh. Ernie Cash was one of those admirers, and after lengthy negotiations, the I's were dotted, and Brick Daniels signed on for Champagne Wrestling. Destiny and greatness beckoned, but as with the dangers of the profession, all it takes is one false move or landing to summons the final curtain call. It happened for Brick on November 18, 1978, at a small-town circuit show in Arlington. Brick Daniels was squaring off against the ape, Andy Montell, midway through the contest. Brick found himself perched on the shoulders of Andy Montell on the top rope as he went to execute his patented ape bomb, which was an aerial throw. Andy's left leg gave way on the bottom rope, plunging Brick into an unrehearsed fall on the back of his neck. Just like that, all the promise of being the poster boy of Champagne Wrestling was ended. Feeling remorse and guilt and looking to find a way out of paying a huge settlement, Ernie Cash took Brick Daniels under his wing and, along with his own son Ted, taught him the ins and outs of the wrestling industry from an owner's viewpoint.
Red 7, it is. You win again, sir.
Smiled Elaine, the hostess, as she looked in the direction of Brick Daniels, awaiting his next move.
I think that's me done for tonight. I know a good thing when I see it. I will take my winnings and bid you farewell.
As Brick bowed his Texas hat before making his way to the cashier table. Las Vegas, what a city, thought to himself. Brick met his first wife Alyssa in Las Vegas at the tender age of 21. A two-year relationship full of highs and lows meant that the matrimony ended on a sour note. Alyssa cursing the day she ever came across the dashing upcoming wrestler. Brick Daniels' on-screen character these days, as a colorful analyst on commentary, was a throwback to the past in terms of wrestling jargon and creating suspense and intrigue around storylines created by the scriptwriters for the various wrestlers. The recent storyline of Brick's bashing of the Mexican Revolution and their unpatriotic actions towards good all USA came to a crescendo at the last pay-per-view. Brick cut a promo in the ring calling on Ted Cash to fire one of the stable members, Humberto, after he burned the USA flag in a fit of rage backstage after himself and his tag team partner, Rojas, lost a tag team match to the hoodlum gang, T-Bone and Osgood. Ted Cash refused to take orders from Brick in a scene which was created to cause tension between two of the spearheads of Champagne Wrestling to bring a sense of shock and awe reaction from the audience in attendance. Sensing all was unwell within the corporation in terms of alliances, created the perfect scene for the Mexican Machete, Hector Moreno, along with Humberto and Rojas, to spring his ambush and unleash a vicious beatdown of the veteran analyst. A script well rehearsed and carried out to aplomb gave Brick Daniels the extended leave of absence he was craving for over the last 2 years. Brick Daniels always maintained close friendship ties with the Cash family. Brick was a beacon of support for Ted Cash when the baton was passed down to Ernie Cash's only son upon his death. Cancer, the ailment that sent of the original entrepreneurs of wrestling to his final resting place in the lush gardens of Tallahona Cemetery. Brick Daniels was the godfather of Ted Cash's only son, Ricky Cash, part-time wrestler himself for Champagne Wrestling, whose sibling rivalry with his sister Charlotte Cash was always one of the go-to storylines used frequently by the scriptwriters. Brick Daniels lodged his winnings in his wallet, which he took out from his velvet line coat. A quick glance at his watch showed him that it was only 10 minutes past midnight. The night was young, far as Brick was concerned. Brick Daniels had no one to answer to, only himself, as three failed marriages had left him with little desire in his later years to share vows. Anyway, how could he explain himself to his two teenage daughters if he was to get married for a fourth time? Thought that brought a fleeting smile to his face.